This is going to be a mini-series on position error correction using GPS. We'll cover three different methods. First, a geometric method for the traditional cloverleaf maneuver that has its roots in the 1970s, where they used radar to measure ground track and ground speed, and then derive wind from these three data points in three different headings. This was later adapted for the GPS. Next, we'll see a slightly better way of deriving delta V by iteratively solving a set of nonlinear equations. And last, we'll jump to a completely different approach that has its roots on Al-Wallace Orbis method from the 2010s, where instead of flying three different headings, you fly a stabilized turn to gather your data and derive your position error correction. Each method is going to have its own dedicated video to cover the concepts, and then a follow-on video to go over the actual data reduction coding in Python. Let's dive in!
The Flight Test Engineering Channel.
If you're a member of the Society of Flight Test Engineers, you can get the main reference that I'm using here, which is the updated 5th edition of the excellent book that is used in the USAFTPS and authored by Russell Erb. Here on the SFT reference handbook page, you can see the 5th edition here, and if you click, you have direct download to this excellent reference here. There are other perks of being a member of the society, like you'll be able to access the paper's database. So if you come here and you click here on the database, you will be able to search all of the papers that were presented on SFTE's symposiums. Also, you'll be able to contact members and fellow FTEs, which is a great place to be engaged, and I highly, highly recommend you be a member of the SFTE. You can check it out at sfte.org, or if you're in Europe, you can check it out at sfte.ec.org, which is the European chapter. Alternatively, you can also find the 4th edition of this reference at the Defense Technical Information Center. If you search for ERB, Russell Erb, you get to this page here, which has the download for the 4th edition. Last, the geometric method that we will cover in the first video is what AC23-8 recommends. All links will be in the video description. Quoting AC23-8, the Global Positioning System, GPS, method consists of using a GPS to determine the ground speed, which is then used to calculate the true airspeed. And when we're going to flight test our vehicle, we start off with the ambient conditions, which includes wind. And one basic assumption for this method is that wind is constant throughout all of the test point execution. So when let's plot first the wind here at the origin of our coordinate system with a vector like this, denoting a wind condition that we don't know. We then set out to do our first test point. So you set your aircraft at one heading, constant airspeed and constant altitude. And from the GPS, you collect what is your ground speed and your track. And when you plot this using the same origin, you can plot your ground speed here. And then assuming that you know true airspeed, this would be the vector that you would see. So then you change your heading and collect the second test point. And we can plot the same over the same coordinate system, like so, using the second run with the second ground speed, and also what would be the true airspeed. Of course, we don't know the blue vectors yet, nor the white ones, but we do know the green vectors and also the tracks. And then proceed to the third heading, and just like we did, you just plot it on the same graph again. Starting from the origin, you plot your ground speed here, considering the track that you get from your GPS. Now, what we need to do is find the tip of our wind vector, right? And the idea here is to find first the bisectors between runs 1 and 3 and runs 1 and 2. So to do that, we connect the tips of the two vectors And then at the midpoint, we draw the perpendicular, like so. So it's easy to find what is the midpoint from the two green vectors, VG1 and 3. And then it's easy also to find what's the slope of this line, and then find what is the perpendicular. So we can find what is this line here, but we still don't know where the tip of the wind vector is. So we do the same for the other pair. We draw also the line connecting the two points, find the midpoint, find what is the slope of this side, find the perpendicular slope, and now it's a matter of finding where these two lines intersect to get exactly the point that our wind vector ends. We need to start another discussion here, because so far our diagram is for a perfect test point, a perfect run, where the wind did not change at all, nor did any of the indicated airspeeds. So they were all perfectly constant. Therefore, we have a unique point here. But in real life, things are not so straightforward. So let's see what happened in real life. We would do the first run with one wind, and that's easy. We would get this wind triangle here with ground speed and this diagram like this. But then as you do your second run, the wind might change a little bit, or your indicated airspeed might change a little bit, and you get a slightly different triangle with a slightly different wind like this. Same thing would happen if you do your third test point and you would get a third wind. Now, when we do the geometric method here, we would do the same idea as we did before. We would find the bisector between test points 1 and 3, find the midpoint, find the slope, and then find the perpendicular slope to find this this line here, this white line. You do the same with the second triangle between test runs 1 and 2, find the slopes and find this perpendicular line here. And we could say that the intersection of these two lines would find our middle wind vector there. That's fine, but we know from this diagram that it's not the truth, right? So you could then say, let's go for the third triangle and find the bisector between test points 2 and 3 and find again what's the perpendicular line. And now what do we have? We have actually three points that we can find, the three wind vectors. And which one is correct? Well, do an approach where we take the average. And by taking the average, that's going to be our best estimate of the wind for these three runs. If we zoom in, you would see that you would have one intersection here, one intersection here, one intersection there for the three perpendiculars. And then your average point is going to be right in the middle of that small triangle that you have in the middle. Okay, so let's jump into Python in the next video so that we see how we can code this and calculate what is the average wind for our three runs, and then find out what is the position error correction using the GPS geometric method. See you there!